thought Tanya would be here.
She's came. Maybe tomorrow. Oh, look. They let him out.
Who?
Reuben. He was the director before Mum took over.
Isn't Loren in the play?
You're right there.
Well, the sight lines are shocking. That sofa needs to be upstage another 2 feet.
I'll mention it. Have fun.
Loren, break a leg.
Thanks. I've not seen me. I am not here. Is anyone sitting there?
You are.
I thought I was early. The place is packed.
Yeah, it's good, eh?
Where are we going to sit?
Where you like. It's general admission.
Yeah, down here looks good.
Hi.
Hey.
Hi, Brooke.
Hi.
Where's Maxwell tonight?
He's working. He sent Daniel a card. He's really sorry he couldn't make it.
Just a little something to say. Darling, you're wonderful.
Oh, thank you.
And one for you. Good. Except I'm not allowed to say good luck, am I? Break a leg. Look at those.
From Reuben.
Oh, he sent me a bunch too. They're beautiful.
Those are the ones I gave him in the hospital.
This is for you.
Oh, he shouldn't have.
Well, I had to do something. My job is over now, isn't it? Except I've forgotten to get something for Lady Bracknell. I hope that's not an omen. Leslie hasn't turned up yet.
Don't worry. Leslie Grant is a professional.
Well, being a professional means turning up for the half-hour call like the rest of us.
Well, it's in town when he's in the country when he's in the... You must be Leslie.
Thank heavens. You'll be wanting to go over your moves. I've kept them as simple as...
Learn the lines and don't bump into the furniture. No coward. But I'm sure if Oscar had thought of it, he would have said it first. It's all in the words, dear. Moves are immaterial.
What's the guy doing playing Lady Bracknell?
Well, no, lots of guys have played their part.
You boys all right?
Yeah, good, thanks.
Just in case you're wondering, this Lady B stands up to pee. All right. Are your parents living?
I have lost both my parents.
Both? To lose one parent may be regarded as misfortune. To lose both seems like carelessness. Who was your father? Was he born into what the radical papers call the purple of commerce? Or did he rise from the ranks of the aristocracy?
I'm afraid I really don't know. The fact is, Lady Bracknell, I said I had lost my parents. It would be nearer to the truth to say they seem to have lost me. I don't actually know who I am by birth. I was found.
Found?
The late Mr. Thomas Cardew found me and gave me the name of Worthing because he happened to have a first-class ticket to Worthing in his pocket at the time. Worthing is a place in Sussex. It is a seaside resort.
Where did this charitable gentleman who had a first-class ticket to this seaside resort find you?
In a handbag.
A handbag?
Yes, Lady Bracknell, I was in...
He's great. So
somewhat large black leather handbag with...
I can't tell anymore.
An ordinary...
Of course he is. He had a brilliant director. And I don't mean Ruben.
James on this Thomas Cardew.
Listen to that. We must be doing something right.
You're wonderful. The lot of you. That must be your influence, bringing out the best in them.
I would have thought that was your job. Really, what have you done with them for the last 3 weeks? Faffed around making cucumber sandwiches? Elizabeth, darling. Uh-huh. Are we still on for drinkies?
Well, sadly, no. I've got another 2 acts of this to drag myself through.
I've never seen Jack played as a South Island cow cocky before, have you?
I know, Elizabeth, but what can you do? Yes, I know.
Knock, knock. Only me. Breaking all the rules, but I couldn't just sit there.
If you've come to give us notes, we don't want them.
I've come to give you a compliment, but I don't suppose you want that either.
I could use one.
You have done a marvellous job. It's going swimmingly.
Thank you.
And I don't say that lightly.
Hello? What have you done to the door?
I haven't done anything. It wasn't me that slammed it.
Get me out of here.
I can't. The lock must be broken.
What's going on?
He's locked himself in the dressing room. I'd happily leave him there if we didn't need him again.
Now, hang on, there must be something we can jimmy it open with.
Trust. A small word of advice while you're all here. Diction, people. Diction.
It's not good. It's not going to budge.
Was there a window?
It's the size of a postage stamp.
Leslie might fit through it, but not the costume.
Stand back, everyone. I'm going to knock the door down.
Well, how?
The hinges are on the wrong side.
Don't be stupid, mate. You're going to hurt yourself.
Oh. Leslie? Leslie?
Oh, dear.
What is going on? Someone came and got TK?
Is he all right?
Well, the door got the worst of it, I think. How'd you get it open?
Daniel took to the lock with a hammer. So, Leslie is all right?
Well, I didn't say that. He was knocked out, and I'm certainly not letting him go back on stage.
But you have to.
I'm not taking any chances. He's going straight to hospital.
I suppose there's nothing for it, then.
I found this lot.
Fantastic.
You'd better start getting changed, then.
I'm not wearing this. It's the wrong period.
It's either that or what you've got on. Leslie's cosy won't fit you.
Oh, Mum, you're not.
And you can make yourself useful as well. Gerald, find her a script.
What for?
I think I know most of the words, but just don't expect them in the right order. I'll look at you if I need a prompt.
Mum, you can't.
Not wearing this, I can't.
Try this. There.
You should have been a costume designer.
What are you saying about my acting?
Are we going on or not? Audience are getting restless.
Off you go. Daniel, do me a favour and give a wave to the lighting guy, please.
Sure.
Go on. I'll be with you in 1.5 pages.
You've read this part for weeks. You're probably not better than Leslie, and you know the moves. You'll be sweet.
Thank you.
What's that for?
I'll tell you later.
Absurd to talk of equality of the sexes. Where questions of self-sacrifice are concerned, men are infinitely beyond us.
We are.
They have moments of self-sacrifice, of which we women know absolutely nothing.
Darling.
Darling.
Lady Bracknell. Good heavens.
Gwendolyn, what does this mean?
Merely that I am engaged to be married to Mr. Worthing, Mama.
Come here. Sit down. Sit down immediately.
Hesitation. Hesitation of any...
Hesitation of all kinds is a sign of mental decay in the young and physical weakness in the old. You will clearly understand that all communication between yourself and my daughter will cease immediately.
She just missed that entire speech.
That's okay, it still makes sense.
On this point, as indeed on all points, I am firm. How old are you, my dear?
Well, I'm really only 18, but I always leave it to 20 when I go to evening parties.
You're quite right in making some slight alteration. Indeed, no woman should ever be quite accurate about her age. It looks so calculating.
Pray excuse me, Lady Bracknell, for interrupting again, but it is only fair to point out that according to the terms of her grandfather's will, Miss Cardew does not legally come of age until she is 35.
That does not seem to me to be a grave objection. 35 is a very attractive age. London society is full of women of the very highest birth who have, of their own free choice, remained 35 for years. Lady Dumbledore is an instance in point. To my own knowledge, she has been 35 ever since she arrived at the age of 40, which was many years ago now.